After a decade of funding and planning delays, roads critical to the Western Sydney Airport are about to be given a $1 billion boost. The state government denies it's acting too late, with some experts worried the airport precinct could turn into a ghost town.
Western Sydney Airport preparing for takeoff, and tonight, funding for the roads that will get you there.
This is the moment where you can start to see the plan coming together.
The state government committing an extra $1 billion.
And not just to catch planes, but crucially for the people in surrounding communities to be able to access the job-creating opportunities.
Elizabeth Drive connecting the new airport with Mamre and Northern Roads upgraded into a divided 4 lanes. Total funding $800 million. Another $500 million will go on widening Mamre Road between Erskine Park and Kemps Creek. And there's $115 million to make Mulgoa Road a 4-lane dual carriageway between Glenmore Park and Jeanette Street.
Must have investments for Western Sydney's future.
But if you're using the airport's new metro, expect a long trip. Currently, getting to St Mary's from the city takes about an hour with more than a dozen stops. You'd then have to change to the metro with another 4 stops to the airport.
But some argue the investment in critical roads and public transport has come too late. Concerned the airport is at risk of becoming a ghost town, far too difficult for travellers to access.
One expert comparing it to China's ghost cities, telling a parliamentary inquiry it could be decades before the necessary transport demands are met.
It has not been left too late.
Grace Fitzgibbon, 7 News.